Okay, it's Independence Day here. This is of the 144 garlic that was planted out there. This is the third picking my wife took out. I'm not going to count them right now, but this is a bunch of garlic. This is all heirloom garlic. Oh, man. We got two bundles in the shed over here, drying out, whatever. And put this out here off the front porch. There's a tomato plant over there. There's a seed that actually had dropped in the ground. I'm going to see if this video will last. Because this is a Sony, folks. And you know, it keeps shutting off on me and changing settings. That one there has got flower on it. So we know it is a tomato. It just started growing when we put this cage around it. There's a little tomato plant down there. I'm not going to zoom in that because that's what happened a lot of times. It would die out. I can't see on the viewfinder right down there. And then we put a cage around this one. That's spinach. Heirloom spinach. And that's lettuce. Cool, crisp, mint lettuce is what it's called. It's not cool, it's not mint, but that's the name. See, it's a propane tank. This was an old cabin in the 1800s. And that was the house where that window is. And that window on the other side of the fireplace that used to be in there years ago, back in the 1800s. And they added on that. And they had, this used to be a back porch, and they closed in, made a kitchen in there. Real kind of small. Here's my zucchini. The green on the right, there's one or two plants here, and then there's one in one hole, and there's two in another hole. So front and back, there's two holes, and this is yellow zucchini. You can see some down here, as a matter of fact. Oh, see how big that one is right down there. There's two of them there. That's about the size most people get in the store. But like I said, they grow large, and they're fine. This is where the 144 garlic were at, right here in the middle. All this grass got in here, took ran away from it. Tracy got down here on her hands and knees and pulled out all this grass. It was just bare grass, I mean bare ground and garlic. Here's my green sweet peas. These gotta be picked here today or tomorrow. You can see how thick these are. Some of them look like big caterpillars almost. But see, there's some of them flat still. On this plastic, which is hot. And then you got purple hull peas right here. I have two peas down in that one, two right there and two right there. So there's at least six plants here. And the black-eyed peas are right there. Look how big that's grown out. And over there, that one looks like it's drying out. It's not getting so good. And there's a pea right there that I don't know what that is. And there's another sweet pea on the corner. And it's dying off. That's about 8-foot sunflower. 8-foot sunflower right there in the middle. I had a sunflower, what I call fence, that goes around the edge, outer edge, about 30 feet back, and then about 70 feet across the back. And then the west end over here is another part of the sunflower, what I call my sunflower wall, to help the overspray from this Monsanto food-like product that they're growing right now. It's feed corn. So, elderberry back there and over there. They're coming back. There were Japanese beetles all over them to kill them. Like I did my okra here. There's one, two, three, four, five, six okra plants. There's five burgundy okra, which is red okra basically. And then there's one green okra right there, the lighter green. It's a real crowded deal too. See, everything is, and here's the watermelon and cantaloupe. This is the southwest corner right here. And it goes out just over halfway going north. This is water, and it's mixed now. I didn't realize it, but seeds must have got mixed. There's a cantaloupe down there. See that one down there? And then there's sweet baby watermelons. I thought I had some, what they call Waltham, which are the long type watermelons. I thought those were planted out here also. I haven't seen one of those either, so somehow, again, seeds must have got mixed. You can see the flowers all over here. Yeah, because it's just over halfway north. And look at it, all the way over here, two-thirds of the garden is the watermelon and cantaloupe. And then there's some cucumbers in here too, by the way, I forgot. You know, I don't know if you can see the pointed leaves. I can't see them right now either, but whew, boy, it's warm out here. It's hot. Oh, here, see this pointed leaf here? This is a cucumber plant. It's growing in there. You can see them in there. I'm going to zoom in if it don't shut off or change settings because it's what's happened in the past. Right there, that's as far as I'm going to go. I think you can see it in there. But there's a little one coming out down there somewhere. I can't see on this viewfinder out here in the heat, in this sun and heat. That's where I got the cantaloupe this morning. It was about 5 pounds. Right there's another one. It's either cantaloupe or honeydew. See, when it's got that skin looking type, that's a cantaloupe. Honeydews are maybe like the one next to it, but like I said, they're all mixed seeds together, I guess. And I planted a couple of peppers out here before, and they're just not growing for anything out here. There's an eggplant in the back corner, and one right there, and then there's basil. Oh, it's going out of focus. Basil, and then eggplant. And there's a purple basil over here by the. Here's another. I think that's a honeydew down there. All the bees are on here. There's a tomato plant right there. And I think that's going to be a cherry tomato plant. I'm not positive. Looking like it, though. See, we have more cherry plants out here, but with the winds that we get out here and the flooding, that one died. That one died. That one died. And look at these others. I had them all tied up and caged up, and when my son-in-law or stepson or whatever it was, son-in-law, was out here last year. We had the tomatoes over there, and he said to untie them. I untied them like this, and they blew up. So I just cut the strings off these and let them go down. Got to watch for those worms. Usually, if you see stuff like this right here, that's a sign that you have hornworms. That's poop. And you get these worms about as big as my ring finger. And I've had 3 or 4 out here so far. I got 3, and my wife got 1. And they'll decimate a plant in one day. I mean, they will totally eat all the foliage off it. The branches have been cut off since then. But you come out here and look at these and see if you see the leaves missing or anything. And if you do, you gotta look closely, because then you'll see. But if you see the poop, you'll know they're eating. But like I said, that's from the ones that we kill off of here. Then we got another tomato plant right here. Again, they're heirloom tomato plants, different names that most people never heard of. I thought I had planted ones that give you like about a pound tomato. But all these are looking like smaller tomatoes, and those look like cherry tomatoes over there. It's a mockingbird up there in that tree. Drive me crazy. Mocking me. Anyway, see. A lot of these, the branches I've peeled off, that they have brown spot, I peel them off thinking I'm afraid to do that, thinking to kill it, but they're coming back after I do that. It makes them healthier. So, baking soda, about 1 good tablespoon to a quart of water for your disease type plants. But see, like now here, you see this right here? I don't want to do this, but I'm going to pop this branch off. I'm going to have to put the camera down and let it hang, because I break the stem there like that. See, I broke this stem off. See the leaves, how bad the disease, they'll just keep spreading. But when you take that off, it should heal better, and you'll get more natural, and it won't kill off the plant. And like I said, this one had 1 tomato that was not good, and I pulled it off about a week ago. There's another one on there. It's about looks like a plum tomato. Same. Then you got 2 on here. And these here are hanging in here. These were all from seed too, by the way, folks. They weren't bought in the store and then put out here. So some of them are coming up big and strong. Whew, boy, it's hot out here on this plastic. And they don't look so hot because of this heat. And tonight, I won't do anything. Tomorrow morning, about 6 o'clock, I'll be out here. And I water it at the base down there. That's eggshell down there, too, that helps keep worms off of them. I just soak them really good. Whew, man. Tomato on that one there. Tomato plant right there. Yeah, flowers on it. Even see, on the other plants, I was sitting there and you tap them if you don't have the bees out. But like I said, we got bees all over these melons, so they'll get to the tomatoes also. That's the reason these honeybees are getting fed out here with natural heirloom pollen. So, phew, man. Yeah. Yeah, 360 acres of Monsanto food-like product. It's a corn-like product is what that is. Yeah, look at where is that? I thought something was. See, here's my peppers. That's why I can't understand. See how small that pepper is right there? It was green. We planted out here before. We've planted them out there. We do the same thing we've done in the past, and they usually grow up about 2 feet tall. There's one right here. Whew, man. And it's just not getting any bigger. I don't understand. There's that eggplant and the other eggplant. Basil. Want to see my wife real fast? I'm not gonna do it. No woman likes to be put on video. See, that's one of my burn barrels I use here. I use the ash for that one. We took this plastic up last fall actually. This was the hardest one to ever get back on here too. God, I can't see. Yeah, like I said, it's about 32, 34 feet across from north to south. And then here west to north is approximately, I'd say right at 60 feet. A little less maybe. But it's hard. But I was going to use the ash and till it in here into the ground. But we tilled it and we put 15, 15, 15 fertilizer in and tilled it all inside here really good. This whole thing. And the number one and number two also. And then put the plastic back on it. And it was hard, folks. But it gives the heat and it helps all this stuff blow up really fast. I can go into November, maybe even December for that, unless it gets real cold, and keep growing. So like down there, that looks like it might be a diseased melon down there. I can't see if that's it on the viewfinder or not. Where's that? Somewhere down there. Yeah, don't shut off. I think that's it right there. But, wow, is it hot. So, and like I say, I should have done this before, but just connect the front two with the back and make it one big garden. It would be a really good sized garden. But see, the plants tend to grow north to south. So we just, let me get over here. Oh man, I'm going to not video record you because there's no such thing as videotape anymore. But anyway, let me zoom out a little bit. See, because you got the back one there. This is number one. Number two is on the other side. The garlic was in the middle. So I wanted to connect these two at the very least. And this won't be as wide as north to south, but it'll be about as long east to west if I connect these. So, and there's a compost bin there, which we have a tomato growing out of that thing. So, you know, we just watered it a couple days ago. It's got a flower on it. My solar panel, put my generator inside there. Whew, man. I don't have my cane on me and this ground is so uneven. And man. Yeah, you get a picture of the map from Google and you'll see a blue pool over there with green water because it sits out here. The water sits out here over the winter generally, except last year we drained it down and we had tadpoles like crazy. We ended up trying to save some. My wife didn't want to kill them all. And I put that grill up on the porch because we moved stuff back there. That looks like hillbilly. That's going to come off the porch. Probably cook out here later with that grill. Put it in the back there. But we put that, the table on it was where that swing is. But my stepson and his girlfriend are coming today. I mean, not today, Friday. And we had the swing over here underneath this tree, which it'll go back to again. And I like it over here in the shade. And what we went put the table back there, like I said, for when we have them here Friday. We're going to stay for a week. So we put that swing up on the porch. And our little illegals that we do feed. We went through 28 pounds of sugar last month, and ran out of sugar with like 3 or 4 days left in the month. And we're trying to keep them out here, you know. I think my wife had, I think maybe about 2 pounds left in the dispenser. I was trying to make one, you put in 1 cup of sugar to 4 cups of water, which is what those larger feeders are. It's about 4 cups of water for 1 cup of sugar. And that takes like 1 cup of water, so 1/4 cup of sugar. But when you mix it, you know, it comes out. So we got 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 20 cups of water, and 1, 2, 3, 4 cups of sugar in those. And then use 1 cup of sugar, and I think those, that one looks like a IV glass jar, like there's one over there too, I didn't see that one over there. And like I say, it's 1 cup water. I mean, 1 cup sugar to 4 cups of water, and then you mix it and you divide them into these. And boy, it's hot out here. We got roses. We've got 2 roses that aren't. These are knockout roses. which I don't care for because they're genetically modified roses. Those, but then we bought one right there, which is Princess Rose and a Queen Elizabeth Rose on the other end. Let me walk. So this is the front of the house. Yeah, it's my Christmas light. I thought it was cool. That's why I left them up for at nighttime. We got motion sensors out here too for lights and the alarm on the house, plus on the doors and windows. So no one can get in. Should be able to get into this house. It's not like most alarms either. So, and yeah, the other rose is right there. The Queen Elizabeth Rose, I think it is called. And I got hummingbird vines, which I might break some of them down because they're going to start overtaking. Last year we were trying to get them, we couldn't get them up, and now they're all over the place after we put down all this black mulch. We did these two gardens with black mulch. There were big bushes out here which we tore up, which was really hard. We got them up finally. And you put these roses in, and you got rosemary on both sides of the garden too. And then elephant ears, of course. And then I don't know what that is. That was here, that bush there. It's got flowers that the hummers go on that too. And then that one there. We got some pink flowers. I don't know if they're out. I saw them the other day. Yeah, they're on the other side of the house. Oh, right there, you can see them. Maybe. Don't shut off camera. Those pink flowers in the middle. The hummers go on those. The hummingbirds, hummers. And then my wife did this. 14 bags of mulch around this tree. And she transplanted these lilies that were by the side of the house, spread out. She got from the nursing home about 8 years ago. We've had them out here. Well, actually, not 8 years ago. 6 years ago. And then she transplanted. There's about five or six around the side of the house and a couple out back. And she put on a circle around the house here. Around the tree, rather. So, yeah. 360 acres of Monsanto food-like products with all the chemicals that go along with it. And then we got our space right in the middle of it. That's why I put that sign up when we moved in here. I bought that sign and I put that up down here at least. That means something, folks. Private property, no trespassing. And I've got it on all four sides of my house also. Ozzy parking only. Whew. Zoom in, I can't really hold the camera steady. Yeah, it's a Sony. So, whew. Yeah, get out of here. Mosquitoes out here. So this is us in the middle of nowhere. Highway's about 3/4 mile on the other side of that field. There is a trailer down around a curve from here. It's about 1/4 mile that way. And down this way here, there's about 3/4 mile, a little more than 3/4 mile. There's a curve down there to the left, to the right. And there's an old cemetery that's got Confederate soldiers up there also. I don't know if you can see it from here with the corn. But then it curves back to the left. And that's where, on Google Maps, that's where the address comes up as being right over there. Where that road is. Yeah, you see that hay? Let me see if I can zoom up there if it don't die out on me. You see some rolls of hay. On Google Maps, that's where it shows this address. Okay, that's why I say you gotta need to go north. Going down, it's the only house on the left. And yeah, go on back that way, and that's where Roger Bird lives. Oh, he's got a thing over there called Bird Cove. His house is like over that way in the trees. Really pretty, had it built nicely, snuggled. He's got his own little pond over there with fish. And his son's got a, in the cove, it's like, Roger's house is right back here, and then his son's got a house way back in the back over there, and his other son's got one over there. So that's called Bird Cove. I think it's spelled B-I-R-D, Bird. So, yeah. That's what it's like down here now. It's hot. Probably about a 92, 93 degrees temperature, plus heat index probably about 103, roughly. I'm just standing here sweating. So, come on down.